script as direction seminars. In other words, learn a bit about the trade, because what I've noticed with the young filmmakers of India, a lot of them have no idea. I mean, they may have many ideas about how to make a film, but they've no idea about the financial side and the way they should approach the subject. So they need help. They need help. They need financial help. A bit more. They need financial help, and they need all sorts of advice that can be given by the professionals who do come here every year, whether it's about direction, script writing, or production, or distribution and sales, and what sort of a film they're actually trying to make. And they don't know, very often they don't really know what they're trying to do. All they know is they don't want to make Bollywood films, they want to make something better than that, or something more. But they've no idea how to go about it, how to get a sales agent, how to apply to festivals, all sorts of things that you have to know if you're going to have a successful career. As an independent filmmaker, it's really difficult now in all countries, let alone India, to actually be an independent filmmaker. It's not easy, and there's not much money in it, and they have to fight like hell. So they need all the advice they can get, and I think the Film Bazaar is gradually giving them a chance not to make the most obvious mistakes. I'm here as a mentor. And as a mentor, sometimes of fiction, sometimes of documentaries. And I can see that we could improve almost all the films with basic ideas as to how to make them better. The question is, once they've shown us the rough cut, have they any money to make the alterations? And that's a very difficult part for them. So the Film Bazaar is gradually developing a support system for them, which is very valuable. And I can't think of anywhere else in India like the Film Bazaar, which gathers so many experts from all over the world to teach, really, to teach how to make films, how to distribute them, how to finance them, almost everything. And it's a great triumph that it's here. It's only a pity that it's on at the same time as the festival, and they don't seem to like each other very much, and that's a pity, because they're both government-operated structures, and they ought to be together. They ought to be friends. There's no doubt about that. So I think that it's doing really valuable work, because there's so much ignorance, not just in India, but particularly in India. I wish there was a similar bazaar in England, really, for the young English and British filmmakers. It'd be a great help to them. But there are more structures to help than there are in India. And I feel very sorry for them. Managed to make a film, but don't really know how to sell it, don't really know how to finance their next one, don't really know what to do to make success of it.
What effort should be made to get the real, buyers and distributors who are based in Europe and America and other part of the world?
How do you mean?
What efforts Film Bazaar can make to bring some more buyers and commissioning editors to this Film Bazaar, because bazaars stand for market.
Yes. Well, the problem is that people view Indian film away from India with almost total ignorance. They just think, oh well, there was Satyajit Ray and there's Bollywood, and there's nothing in between, you know. And very often, festival organizers find it difficult to get good Indian films for their programs, because the letters are not answered, there's a lot of bureaucracy involved. So often the festivals will go without a single Indian film. A, because they haven't seen the right ones, they haven't been here, they don't know much about it. And B, because it's very, very difficult to actually get the business going, get the letters replied to, get the very good prints. You must have a good print. You must have good subtitles. You must know what you're doing. And very often they don't. So a lot of people who ought to be here don't come here yet. It's gradually increasing, there's no doubt about it. But there should be more people here and more concerned with Indian films, because I've found throughout Europe there's this idea, it's just Bollywood. And that's fun, but you know, the serious filmmakers are not here, we don't know who they are. And there's a great deal of ignorance about India. That's partly Indians' fault, because it's a little, it seems to be a great big world of its own, which doesn't talk to the outside very much. Except Bollywood, of course, does, because they can make a lot of money in England and America now, and in Australia. And they make their films on Sydney Bridge and London Bridge and all sorts of strange places, you know. So Bollywood is caught under the fact that they are dealing internationally, like Hollywood. But the poor Indian filmmakers who want to do something different have no idea. And they don't help themselves by having enough experience. And they say, oh, well, maybe I can go to Cannes with this film. And you say, well, it's not really a Cannes film, but it would be good for Moscow, or it would be good for Carlo Vivari. They haven't got the advice to do the right thing. And they need a European sales agent to take a look at their film and say, well, this is a film that's a perfect fit for this festival or that festival. Or if they go to Cannes, sometimes if they're not in competition, they give up. When you have to say, but there's the director's fortnight, there's the critics' week, there's all sorts of sections at Cannes where you could go. But they think if they're told, sorry, we're not taking it for competition, that's the end of the thing. So there's this terrible ignorance about the rest of the world, which is actually quite depressing. Think of South Korea. They send them the smartest prints and the best subtitles, and they send the films early, and they argue, and they say, and they try and get their films in any section that will have them for any festival. And they do tremendously well compared to India. Not with any better films necessarily, but with this competent structure. They send people around all the festivals to find out how the festivals operate, and then they work accordingly. I don't see that happening in India very much yet. So the Bazaar has still got a lot of work to do, as they would admit, in trying to get more people here, but they have financial constraints too. It's expensive business getting people, flying people over and putting them up in a 5-star hotel, etc. It's very difficult. And now with the new regime in India, nobody knows what's going to happen, whether their money will be cut, whether the new regime is interested in the work they're doing or not. So it's a little bit precarious. But the advances that have been made have been quite considerable. And I've noticed it as a mere mentor to the documentary films and sometimes the feature films, that young Indian filmmakers are beginning to understand the difficulties they face. And I think, for instance, the documentaries this year were stronger than last year. But there isn't one of them that couldn't do with a lot of improvement, you know? Basic improvement, and that's what we're here for. But if they've got to reshoot, or they've got to re-edit, where's the money coming from? That's the problem.
One last question that